Hey folks, it's Gail from Seattle Coffee Gear, and we're going to do a compare today between the Jura A1 and the Intellia Deluxe from Seiko. We're doing this because they are similar price points, and I'm just going to go over the features of each one of the machines. Let's talk about the Jura first. The Jura, the one thing it does not do, it does great coffee, but it does not do milk. There is no steamer on this machine, so this is coffee only. Three programmable buttons up here at the top. And you can also switch between 7 grams of coffee that's ground to 10 grams. Those two choices and those two choices alone. Right back in here, you have 5 ounces of bean capacity. That's a little bit smaller than the Intellia Deluxe. We also have a 37-ounce water tank right back here, a little bit smaller with the Jura filter in there. The footprint of the machine itself is smaller. It has a bypass doser. That's the grinder setting. This is the bypass doser. This is where you can grind the, you know, set the fineness of your grind in the bean hopper. On off button right here. Of course, it knows that I opened up the bypass doser, and it's gonna tell me, it's just gonna go back to, Gail, you didn't put enough coffee in there, so I'm not gonna do it. Spouts that go up and down in the typical fashion give you a pretty good cup height. Dregs drawer, drip tray, all come out right there. Plastic casing all around on this machine. Little narrower footprint. One other thing I wanted to talk about on this machine, the Jura, is it has PIP, pulse extraction process. Which, what is that? If you're brewing with that particular process, it pulses, boom, 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 boom. So it cuts back the pressure that's actually going through the coffee, gives you something that's a little bit better tasting according to Jura. The other thing on the Jura products is the brew unit does not come out. The only way to clean it is to put a tablet down the bypass toaster. Haven't found that to be an issue. Also, you either descale or you use the filters on these machines. They don't give you the option to do nothing. You have to use one or the other. You either have to use the filter or you have to descale it. Let's go on over to the Intellia Deluxe from Seiko. Plastic casing here, stainless steel front, plastic casing on the side. A little bit wider footprint. This one has a cup warmer up here. I didn't mention on the Jura, but it does not have a cup warmer. This machine will do steaming of the milk as well as extraction of the coffee. So, comes with the Cappuccino Torre, and we have the Panarello on here. You can put a Panarello on. It does not come in the box, but it's capable of it, so you can do that. It also has 5 bean settings, everything from 7 to 10 grams. Actually gives you the same range. This one just has 2 settings, but this will give you 5 settings. 2 programmable drinks that you can program the volume of, and bypass doser right up here. And a digital readout. No digital readout over here. Drip tray, you know, same story. Water tank is right out the front over here. Water tank is 53 ounces, dregs drawer right over here, come out the front. Everything kind of nice coming out the front. That's a good thing. Beans right here, 10.5 ounces of beans versus the 5 ounces over here, so a little bit different. There's about 10 settings over here for changing your grind, the fineness of the grind, so you have a lot of control in that way. Did I mention the cup warmer? I think I did. So that's the overview of these two machines. If you need any more information, obviously go to our website or give us a call and we can go over more of the features or pros and cons with you. But, you know, we just kind of wanted to do these two because they're a similar price point and we thought you would want to know, right?